So with so many people looking to move here, and a lot of my clients who move here have never even been here before, so I asked a question in a Facebook group. What are some things that you think people need to know before moving to Arizona? And the response was overwhelming. Welcome back to the channel. It's Rich Breckland, your Arizona real estate agent. Like I said, we're gonna talk about what you need to know before moving to Arizona. And I posted this in a Facebook group and had over 600 comments. Some people are, they have very, very strong beliefs about a lot of things, specifically politics. I really don't wanna bring politics into this page, this channel.
Do not come.
I'm gonna come.
With anything political, left or right, or whatever, you're going to have that. But one of the first comments that I saw that stuck out to me was the lack of Midwest nice. Now, like this person said, you know, Midwest nice. Now, if you're from the Midwest, you know exactly what this means. It's something I said when we moved here. We came from the Midwest. And to me, Midwest nice is just, you know, talking to your neighbors, putting your shopping carts away. Arizona, I don't know what the problem is with some of you here that don't put them away. Don't take that comment with thinking everyone is rude and no one is friendly. Again, with so many people moving here, and especially from Cook County, I think that's the number third county moving to Maricopa County. But we've met plenty of Midwest nice people who aren't necessarily from the Midwest. But I'll say this, when you do connect with someone who is from the Midwest, it's almost like you instantly know it. And one of you will ask each other, you know, hey, where are you from? And then they'll tell you, oh, I'm from, you know, Illinois or Iowa. It's like, I knew it. You can just tell when you're talking to people. Another comment that came up quite a bit was the bad driving. So not just bad driving, but people are in a hurry, aggressive. There are a lot of traffic accidents, not just, you know, on the highway and interstate, but also just around town. I don't know if people are staring out in the mountains, blinded by the sun, but just slow down. We have a lot of, I don't say a lot, but more, I recognize it here more than when we live in Illinois, of wrong way drivers. I don't know how hard it is to drive the correct direction on the highway, but you know, the 202, the 60, it's just common. Maybe everyone is drunk. Well, that's actually a lot of the times when they're driving the wrong way on the highway. It's the only explanation I can think of is you must be smoked if you're driving the wrong way. But unfortunately, it does lead to a lot of traffic fatalities. If you're coming here, just pay attention. Again, you have people from all over the country, even the world, you know, choosing to move here and then pick up, start driving, different patterns all coming together at once. And people are driving nuts. The roads are nice and smooth, so people think they can go 125 miles an hour. But yeah, that is a real thing. So this person said, don't expect Southern hospitality and good food. Well, again, that kind of goes back to the Midwest nice thing. We've met some amazingly nice people, super generous, and some people are just kind of cold, standoffish, really didn't care to talk to us at all. And as far as the food goes, it depends what you're looking for. Now, again, we're from the Midwest. I'm very easy to please. We found some great restaurants. We found some that are just eh. One thing though I have been surprised of is we haven't found a really great Mexican restaurant that we love. I thought when we moved here, like, oh, Mexican food is gonna be off the charts, but really it's, we found a lot of the same. Now we found some good places, but nowhere that really just, you know, blows me away that is, you know, amazing food that I would always, you know, recommend. To me, it's just all pretty much average. See, from this person, they commented, you know, they came from the South and they found the people here to be nice and the food to be good. So again, when you ask people their opinion, you're gonna get all over the board. But again, our general experience is, for the most part, people are, they're friendly. So next, be aware of, you know, the wildlife. And I'm not talking about, you know, the coyotes or javelinas, but, you know, your scorpions, snakes, spiders, lizards. Now, some people act like, you know, they have rattlesnakes crawling through their front room and you always have to be on high alert. I'm not saying you can't have that, but it depends on where you live in Arizona or in Phoenix Metro. So if you're in a new construction area and you're back up to the mountains, you know, all that disruption, you know, that happened in an animal's home, so they've already established that habitat, you're probably gonna have a higher chance of, you know, snakes and scorpions and those things. But we haven't seen any in our home, any snakes, scorpions, anything. You can also get your home treated. Very, very reasonable to have a pest control company come out and treat for scorpions. That way you don't have that. You know, I'd rather have a rattlesnake come near my home than a scorpion because I can't see, I mean, scorpions are tiny. If you've never seen one in the daylight, They're small, they blend in well. You can definitely go out and find them at night with the black light, which is cool. And I looked up some stats as far as, you know, deaths in the US when it came to rattlesnakes and scorpions. And I think it's been over 20 years since someone has died. Now, one of you are gonna go find that and say that I'm wrong, but I don't think I am. So it's, your odds of dying are far greater from some other random things than a scorpion or a rattlesnake. This is one that I was not expecting. I thought something was wrong. Like, what is going on? Who mixed up our faucets? But turning on the cold water in the summer, pretty much any time that isn't winter, you're not gonna get cold water. I mean, it makes sense, right? 115 degrees, the pipes, no one's cooling the pipes, and your water is going to be, it's warm. So brush your teeth with warm water. That was something, it was weird at first to get used to it. Again, if you're someone who wants to take a cold shower, that's not happening in, you know, June, July, August, September even. Having water is key. So we go through a lot of bottled water, water filtration. If you do move here, you've already lived here and you need help with a water filtration, reverse osmosis system, I have a great contact that can hook you up with that. And he's awesome, takes really good care of my clients. But yeah, water is key, cold water even better, but don't expect to get it from your tap. So another thing is, you know, the sunshine. Before we lived here, again, coming from Illinois with our girls, with our dog, you know, we're just used to normal life. We thought, you know, the seasons, I don't say seasons, but we're just used to what we were used to. And then we moved here and obviously I knew it was warm. I knew it was the desert. I knew there was more sun, but you really don't get to understand what that is until you live here with 300 plus days of sunshine every year. It does make a difference. It makes a difference in your overall well-being. I mean, vitamin D is good for you and just overall happiness. Having the sun out is so, we love it. It would be so hard for us to go move somewhere else that did not have this much sunshine. And I mean, the views, you know, no matter where I'm at, typically you have awesome mountain views. I love the landscape and the sunsets here are phenomenal. Now I prefer, I don't know what it is, but the sunsets toward the colder months versus the hotter months. But either way, the sunsets, sunrises, if you are someone into photography, or maybe you want to be an IG influencer, take some pics out in the mountains, there'll be no shortage of places where you can go do that. So, you know, the views and the sun and just that overall climate here is awesome. The weather, everyone knows this is, you know, hot as the sun for the most part. You know, 115 degrees is hot. It's gonna change what you do. Now for us, you know, when we moved here, you know, a couple years ago, it was in the summertime. So we picked the absolute worst time to move here. But we're excited to live here and it didn't stop us from doing much. Now, we weren't going outside hiking in the middle of the day. You know, we were using precautions, just being smart about it. But for the most part, we would do stuff in the early morning or late at night. When the sun went down, even though it was still 100 at, you know, dark time, it wasn't awful. You know, the sun makes a huge difference. And then another thing where I was shocked at, you know, it does get humid. There are mosquitoes and the monsoon season is, you know, different than I was expecting, but also it also got colder than I was anticipating. I'm like, what? I'd like to speak to the manager of Arizona. This winter is a little more winter than I would like. However, that was me, I think, getting soft of living here. And, you know, it wasn't Illinois, there wasn't snow. It still warmed up, you know, in the 60s at some of the coldest days. But in the morning, you know, you're going to need to turn your heat on. So don't get rid of your long sleeves just yet, because for a few months out of the year, you'll probably need them. So let me know, what did I miss? If you already live here or you've been here a ton, what are some things you think people need to know? And if you're ready to move here, make sure you watch these next videos and reach out to me so my team and I, we can help you get into a great place. Can't wait to take care of you. My contact info is below and I'll see you on the next one.